All right, so there's only a few things that we need to do before we go ahead and get our MA.X installed. The first is we're going to attach our flexible spout. Now, you'll notice that the end has plastic threads and that there's a black rubber O-ring at the end. If you start out this install and that O-ring is broke, give us a call because it's going to leak from here. We need to send you a new O-ring right away. The chances of that happening are very minimal, but I wanted to cover it in this video. Now, when you insert this, you want to make sure that you're not forcing the piece in there, and you're certainly not forcing twisting of the threads. If you notice here, I'm turning this only with two fingers. So it's very, very easy to screw in. If you have to use any more force, another method is you can just bend the tip up and turn it like this. But if you have to use any force to turn this in, you're stripping the threads. Back it out, restart. It should go in very, very easily. If it's not going easily, stop, take it out, and reset it again. Once you've reached the bottom of the threads, take your finger, your thumb, and your forefinger inside here and give it 2 to 3 more turns until you feel that it's become nice and snug. There is no reason to over-tighten this fitting. It should only be hand-tight and snug. There should be no water dripping out of the fitting. When you turn the machine on, if you see any water dripping here, then go ahead and give it another quarter or half turn, but no more than that. The other thing you'll notice about these spouts is the spouts tend to hold their position very well, but once water is running through it, it might cause it to droop. If that's the case, you can take your thumb and forefinger down here and your thumb and forefinger here and just tighten the hose up a little bit. That'll make it hold its shape a little stronger. Don't wrench hard. Don't go out of your way to really tighten it because you can break this. Just one half of it or one quarter of a turn is all that's needed. And it will hold its shape just fine, and it will turn in any direction that you choose. So putting the spout on is the first installation method. The second is, and you want to set some kind of protection down on the table, be it a plastic bag or a towel, and set the machine over onto its side. I'm going to use the opposite side of the handle so I don't scratch it up, and I'm going to set it down on this side. The main thing is I want to expose the bottom panel to you guys. You'll see that there is two connections here, and they both have a blue spindle in them. Now, this is the point where I should really show you how to work a quick connect fitting. I'll just pull a little tubing out here, and we have a quick connect fitting here. Now, I don't know if you'll see it on the video, but there is some collars that are loose at the end of these quick connect fittings. And the way these connect is very simple. You just take the tube and push it in all the way until it won't push in any further. And that's it. You have a finished sealed plumbing connection. These are some of the most advanced plumbing connections in the entire plumbing industry. It's called quick connect. They almost never leak, and they're just as solid as metal connections. The only thing is, you will never be able to pull this fitting out of here. The only way to get the tube back out is to take your fingernail and push down on the outer collar and pull. So let's do this again so everyone can see. Push in all the way till it won't go in any further and pull out. That's how you know it's in. To remove it, press down on the collar. You might have to use two fingernails and pull it out. Now, if there's water pressure in this line, generally you'll see that the collar is pushed out. The water pressure is pushing the collar out. To get this line off, you'll need to release the water pressure from the machine. The easiest way to do that is to turn off your cold water supply under the sink, come up top, turn the power button on the machine so it can release water pressure, then you'll be able to remove the line from here. You'll notice these two blue stoppers at the bottom of the machine. These are here to prevent any water leaks. into the machine. You'll go ahead and remove both of these by pressing on the collar and pulling them out. Please never throw these out or lose them. You're going to want to store them in your accessory compartment, because if you ever ship the machine back to us for service or warranty, these will absolutely need to be in place. So again, please do not lose or throw these out. We'll go ahead and keep them, as in any spare part that you have should be kept in this accessory box permanently. You'll notice on the bottom there are two of these connectors. One is an inlet, one is the outlet. The outlet is easy to recognize because it has an acid flow control right next to it, and it also says out on the top side. Right here where my finger's rubbing, it says out right in the plastic body. This one down here says in. So connecting the ionizer is really this simple. You're going to have your water supply that's going to go to the in line right here, and then you're going to have your acid or your drain supply go right here. Now what we're going to do for the next segment is we're going to go ahead and move on into our install area, where we're going to show you actually how to install this in your kitchen. Be right back.